Welcome, learners. I'm Anna. Today, we're diving into an inspiring speech by Shah Rukh Khan, a renowned Bollywood actor. This speech gives us a wonderful opportunity to enhance our English grammar skills and enrich our vocabulary. Ready? Let's explore.
Okay, so good evening, boys and girls. Exams are over. If I may say so, damn school is over, which seemed an impossibility just a few years back. That horrible math or physics or whoever your least favorite teacher is, you will never have to see again. That PE coach who has all out to get you is done and dusted. I know everybody's looking there. You want to party now, relax, hang out with the beautiful friends you've made in the last 13 years, 14 or some less. The last thing you really want to do is sit here and listen to someone give you advice on life lessons and what the future holds for you. And to top it, my qualification to be doing this is zilch, nada. Not at all, nothing. Really, apart from the fact that Neeta and I are friends and thus I have some benefits.
In this section, SRK uses the past perfect in I have had, which indicates a connection between the past and now. Notice the expression zilch, nada, not at all, nothing. These all mean zero or none. Example, I have zilch experience in dancing.
My reason to be here is the same as that of your elder brother or your sister being allowed to do things that you're not allowed to do at home. I'm like them, older, that's all. So if you think that I have had a successful career, as I was getting very embarrassed when David was recounting, because also it's been so many years since I've got an award now, yeah. It's just like two. Gotta work harder. So also if you think I've had a successful career, a great past performance and my experiences of it are no assurance that it'll work in the future for you or work for you at all. And anyway, none of what I say today you will remember as soon as you're out of here. Or maybe even earlier, because you're still sleeping from the big party you guys had last night.
Here, Khan uses the phrase, may make sense to, which means something might be understood or seen as logical by someone. For instance, the idea may make sense to him, but not to me. Also, he uses the future simple in I promise to keep, showing an intention for the future.
What I say may make sense to your mom or dad, who will remember it some years down the line, and they will also remember it for all the inappropriate things that I'm going to say tonight. But you are here, and so am I, so I promise to keep this extremely crisp and sharp. 20 minutes, tops. But be rest assured, I understand if some of you walk out in the middle of my speech for bladder control reasons. Feel free to do that. Feel free because that's what essentially my talk is about. Feeling free, the freedom to be yourself. To listen to your inner voice and never let anyone tell you who you are or who you ought to be, including me.
He emphasizes the phrase, be yourself, which means to act authentically. Example, it's important to always be yourself. He also uses the modal will, as in you will chance upon, to indicate a possibility or likelihood.
These are the only years of your life in which you will be allowed to make regret-free mistakes. As you do so, you will chance upon your dreams and hopefully make a happy life out of their fulfillment. Your annoying mother, who is still depressed that your handwriting is bad. You know, she doesn't understand. If it was bad 5 years ago, chances are that your handwriting is not going to improve for the rest of your life, ever. Ma'am, get that clear. It's not going to happen. But let me assure you, squiggles and ants and mosquitoes on paper won't kill your career. Any doctor here will tell you, indecipherable hieroglyphics may actually be a career booster.
The term grudge means to resent or feel bitter about someone or something. For example, she holds a grudge against her former boss. Khan also humorously comments on bad handwriting and draws a connection using the conjunction but, as in, it's not going to happen. But let me assure you.
Basically, just don't grudge the old man and the old bag, ever. All us parents try to do is to make you happy with your choices by annoying you with ours that are actually your choices anyway. But you just don't know it yet. Your hormone levels are too high for you to understand this confusing logic. All you want to be is yourselves. And you're quite sure you know what that is. And I'm here tonight on your side only to confirm your conviction as you set forth into the big bad world from the loving shelter of Mrs. Neetha Ambani and all these wonderful and beautiful and warm teachers and faculty who have nurtured you to embark on your own journey through life.
In this part, Khan delves into his personal history, using past simple like was for describing conditions in the past. The word privilege means a special right or advantage. Example, having a good education is a privilege.
I was talking about parents because I think tonight is about parents. So I'm going to tell you something about my parents. My mother was top class. She was really cool. She loved me unconditionally, was beautiful, like all mothers are, and believed I will be the most famous man in the world, and I could do no wrong. And my father was a gentleman. He was very educated, masters in law, extremely intelligent, knew 7 languages, had traveled the world, knew his politics, fought for the freedom of our country, India, and excelled at sports like hockey, swimming, and polo. He could cook and recite poems and knew the capital of every country in the world. My father was also very, very poor. He was unemployed and struggling to make ends meet for 15 years of my life that I had the privilege of knowing him. From when I was 10 to when I was 15, not being able to afford fancy gifts for me, he would wrap up something old that belonged to him in newspapers and declare it as a birthday gift when my birthday came along. When I was 10, my father gave me an old chess set.
Khan relates life to chess, using similes and metaphors. Notice the use of the conditional if, as in, if you don't look out for, which indicates a possible condition and its result. Also, the word adversary means opponent or enemy.
Chess is a reflection of life, they say, and as cliched as it sounds, it's probably true. The first thing it teaches you is that every move has a consequence, whether you perceive that it does or does not. Nothing you do, not a single moment, is empty of living. So think of things through, not always, but often enough, so your life does not feel as black and white and as uniform as the squares on a chessboard. Sometimes, in order to move forward, you might need to take a few steps back. And there's no loss in doing something that hurts in the short run, but proves worthwhile in time. Sometimes, the queen might seem sexier. They always do. But if she gets taken by your adversary straight after you save her, then you might be better off saving your castle or the bald bishop instead. So don't always choose that which seems more desirable if something tells you it's going to get you into a whole lot of trouble. What I mean is also about tonight, drive home while your wits are about you instead of staying and getting stoned senseless after the party here. You can't get anywhere in chess if you don't look out for the little ones around you, the small pawns. Life is like that too. If you forget the smallest of your people or become foolish enough to imagine that the little graces you are given are of no value, you end up nowhere.
The phrase take for granted means to not appreciate something because you assume it will always be available. Example, we often take our health for granted. He also uses the future simple will have to indicate possession in the future.
When you look around you, learn to notice all the tiny little things that make your existence privileged and special. Just the fact that you are here, in this very moment, at this fantastic school, in the company of such adoring parents, is the product of immense love, hard work, and sacrifice on the part of many people present here. Taking your blessings for granted is the most ungracious stupidity, both in chess and in life. And you start on this journey with a brave heart about you. If you live life with grace towards those around you, you'll get where you have to, and it won't astound you. If it isn't Ferraris and a White House that downed you, you won't need an entourage to always surround you. It's your truth you will have that will shelter and ground you. And you'll remember this day as the day that unbound you. From the walls of this beautiful school and the teachers, exams and all the rules that sometimes seem to hound you. And let me tell you, you all will be successful. let me remind you. Now, it was remind, but because it's not rhyming.
Khan uses a playful change of words with remound, showcasing language's flexibility. The modal can, as in, you can't get anywhere, indicates ability or possibility.
So boys and girls, go forth, be free, have fun, make wrong choices, make mistakes. You will still succeed because the gift of education you have from this wonderful institution called Dhirubhai Ambani International School, the love Nita has given you, and the genes that your parents have provided you with will always look after you. And when you succeed, don't forget to thank your least favorite teacher, because he or she actually cared for you the most. Love you all and be happy.
In his closing, Khan encourages the audience using imperatives like be free and make mistakes. The phrase look after is a phrasal verb, meaning to care for or attend to someone or something. Brilliant work, learners. We've dissected Shah Rukh Khan's speech, understanding vital grammar rules and enriching our vocabulary. Keep revisiting the speech to identify more elements and improve your grasp of English. Till next time. Visit our site, EnglishSpeechChannel.com, for exclusive access to video transcripts, offline audio, English lessons, and private classes. Don't forget to explore our free and new ebooks. Also, subscribe to our weekly newsletter for the latest updates. Links in the description below. Thanks for your support.